When crisis strikes, the universe turns to one superhero. One of great strength and moral character. Quick wit and inventiveness. Incredible speed and flexibility. But most importantly, floppy ears and a big gun. Epic Mega Games presents a game by Arjun Brucey and Cliff Blazinski, Jazz Jackrabbit. Hey, it's Coolio if you don't know, and we are playing Jazz Jackrabbit for the DOS. Alright, let's take a look at some storyline, shall we? This turtle has kidnapped this rabbit in order to conquer this planet. It's up to this rabbit to destroy this turtle with this gun. To save her and this. That's pretty straightforward, isn't it? Welcome to Jazz Jackrabbit. Jazz is a speedy, colorful action game unlike any other on the PC. Very true. In order to play Jazz, you must understand three rules. 1. Run like the wind. That's usually a bad idea. 2. Shoot everything that moves. That's usually a good idea. And 3. If you can't shoot it, take it. That makes sense. So here is the full story. There's not much of it, but it's a little more detailed than what we just saw. The notorious leader of the turtle terrorist, Devan Shell, has kidnapped the beloved rabbit Princess Eva Earlong and has inhabited the galaxy with his goons. Is all hope lost? No way! Enter Jazz Jackrabbit. The galactic rabbits want revenge and it's your job to extract it. You have to save Eva Earlong and prevent Devan Shell from financing his maniacal plot of turtle domination by swiping the goods out from under his slimy beak. Pretty standard controls, left and right to move, space to shoot, alt to jump. I've changed those around a bit for it to work on my computer, but hey, it works. Pause, quit, and slow motion mode that we are not going to be using, except maybe to prove a point at the first level or something, I don't know. There are 5 different weapons in the game. There's a blaster, which has unlimited ammo, but kind of weak. There's a toaster, a pretty standard weapon. A little more oomph than the blaster. The RF missile goes off in 2 directions, up and down in front of you. The launcher bounces across the ground, and the TNT stays in place and delivers a large explosion. Not usually very effectual, but it is the most powerful weapon in terms of firepower. Here's some game-winning strategies, running while jumping. Higher jump, it's pretty standard platform trope there. And there are secrets all over the place by either running through walls or just blasting through them. Can you find the secret birdland in episode 1? I think so. I'm gonna try to find secrets. I know where a couple of them are, but most of the time it's just going to be a matter of running into them and collecting them. I tend to be pretty good at exploring all over the place. Jive from the Jazz creators. It's hard to draw a sexy rabbit. 2 words. Jeremy Bernal. Moving on. It's lousy. It sucks. I don't think it sucks. Maybe it did early on, but that was a long time ago. Ha! Our bonus stages are 3D. Yes, they are, Cliff. Yes, they are. I think Jazz should be a squirrel. No! No! Bad Mark Ryan. What is wrong with you? I just optimized my code. The game is 20% faster. It certainly is, Arjan. Do you think it's too fast? I don't think so, Tim. 99 frags and still kicking. And so how long have you worked at Hooters? Moving on. And these are the people to blame for this game. Arjun Brucey for programming and game engine, making the engine 20% faster, as he said. Design and graphics, Cliff Blazinski. Animation and cinematics, Nick Stadler. Music, Robert A. Allen. Sound and system, Joshua Jensen. And sound effects, Nando E. Wegg. And everything is so good in this game. So pretty, and the music is excellent. And finally, this game is not shareware, and joining the Epic team is not nearly this simple anymore. So, let's get this game started, shall we? There are four difficulties in this game, and mostly just controls how much damage Jazz takes per hit. I think some of the higher settings also add more enemies and easy mode, which is also known as baby mode, takes some away. But we are not a baby, nor are we Hopping Mad or the Incredible Hulk, so we're gonna set this to medium. Now there are 9 episodes, there are the 6 that originally came with Jazz Jackrabbit, and also 3 for the CD version. Now, I don't have Holiday Hare, so we're not gonna be playing that, but we're gonna be playing everything else. There's Turtle Terror, Ballistic Bunny, Rabbit's Revenge, Gene Machine, Chases On, The Final Clash, and the CD episodes Out of This World, Turtle Soup, and Wild Wabbit. You can also play the bonus levels separately, but we're not going to be doing that. We're going to be running into a few bonus levels here and there anyway, so for now, let's get started. Oh, that's neat. Let's get started with Turtle Terror. And we start our game on Diamondus. Alright. Now you can see how fast this this game is. It's probably actually not as fast in the recording because my computer is not great. But we're gonna make the best with what we got. Yeah, rabbits do not stink. That's what I think of your signs. I'm probably going to save... Ow. That was rude. I'm gonna save the toaster for later on. Ah. But just to give an example, there's a slow motion mode, which I believe was originally labeled as turbo mode or some such. And yeah, you can see that the game is considerably slower with this on. So we're not going to be using that. We're going to be going full speed. Oh man! Run through the things! Hey. Hey, a fair amount of toaster ammo here. This is a checkpoint. Shoot it, and if you die, you'll return to that point, but I'm intent on not dying. Secrets. Those are rapid fire guns. Now I can hold down the fire button to just keep on shooting. Ah. Grabbing all the floppy disks. Can't get enough of my floppy disk. Yes, I said that. Anyway. Yeah. You turtle jerk. Want that invincibility? There we go. Make waste of our enemies here. Eh, what's up here? What's up, Doc? I promise you that is the only time I will make that joke during this LP. However, that is the only joke I promise not to make again. Alright. So, that didn't take very long. Kinda blew through the level and didn't see everything, but, ew. That doesn't look correct. There we go. Yeah, I'm playing this game on an external hard drive, so sometimes the game might freeze if the hard drive needs to spin up. But it should only be temporary freezes, not too much to worry about. That's not to say that I'm not worried, because For various reasons, this is the sixth time I tried this episode. And this is the only time I've actually gotten to level 2. Yay, I've made it back to the start! I'm good at video games-age. So, the way that I'm planning to do this is one episode per episode, which would lead to 9 episodes total, because there are 9 episodes total. Now, the help file said something about a secret birdland. The birdland is in Diamondus level 2. So we gotta be on the lookout for that. I got a little shield here. Yeah, which we promptly waste, because why not? Yuck! There we go. Got ourselves a 1-up that we probably won't be needing, but better safe than sorry. Rabbits do not stink! Except for the ones that have just farted. Ah! Some additional time. I don't imagine we're going to be needing it, but hey. Now, I don't remember the bird's name, but basically he's going to be hanging around and providing a little bit of cover fire for us until we get hit. As soon as we get hit, he's going to run off, so got to be careful. Ah. As you can see, no more bird. Sad times at Degrassi Junior High. There we go. Getting hit an awful lot here. Don't like it. Do not like it. I think I actually grabbed another time power-up, which is strange. Ah! Die, monster! Die! Got some more shieldage. I think we're about at maximum rapid fire now. Or one might say rabbit fire, am I right? Now we're going super speed! Whee! So I saw a 1-up over there. Can I get the 1-up? It's over there! Eh! There we go. Whee! Run like the wind! So much for that. Kinda wasted most of it because I was trying to get the 1-up that I don't need. And as Chris Hardwick would say, points! Anyway. Yes, that was incredibly lame, but you all know that I am incredibly lame. If you don't know this by now, then what is your thing? CMB, the initials for Cliff Blazinski. I'm hoping I haven't missed the super secret bonus land of the bonus bonus. I saw that gem there. That will take us to a 3D bonus level after we finish this. How do I get up there? It's not a spring. Aha! Also, I'm starting to think that I've completely missed the secret super duper. Yeah. One up. Wow, getting a lot of lives here. Is it too late to turn back? See if I can use a modicum of platforming skill to make it up to the thing. Yerg! This feels like it should be doable. Screw it. Okay. Dang it. Yeah, because I don't want to hit the sign at the end of the level right now. I want to see if I can find the secret thingamabob. Thingamabob or doohickey. I'm starting to think that it's too late for that. It's too late, baby. It's too late. Well, is it though? It would help if I remembered at all where it was. Yeah, their legend doesn't seem to be a way to actually go back. Oh, that is the sucks. I really wanted to show you the secret bird world. Oh. Back in my day, we didn't have a secret bird world. Also, I used to be some sort of pop country artist who was kind of terrible. Yeah, we're not gonna get those rapid fire guns, but I don't think those are very gettable. I need the launcher, and I don't have the launcher. So let's just go ahead and finish the level. Level clear! Alright. Now it's time for bonus. Now in this bonus, we have to collect 30 gems that are scattered around the maze. There are generally more than 30 gems in the maze. It's just a matter of finding 30 of them. That's just gonna bump you, try to bump you back and steer you off course and such. Pressing forward twice makes you roll, which can save you some time as long as you don't run into a wall. And there's one thing that you do have to worry about other than the time limit, which is the exit sign. But we didn't run into one of those, so Jazz is going to hiccup his way to an extra life. Now it's off to Tube Electric! Okay. This level is a little more high-tech, let's say. Gotta worry about the ballistic dudes. Hey, there's some weapons in there. Give me some of that. Now we have launchers. Now, I did have a bit of a practice run at this, and I kind of went out of my way to collect as much as I could. Whoops. I might not bother quite so much with it for this, since everybody is watching. They want action. Not looking around for things that I've already passed by and have no chance of actually redeeming. To the left. To the left. To the left. To the left. There's nothing there. Jerk game. Okay, where am I supposed to be going now? Oh, okay. Now, the little turtles can't hurt you, so don't worry too much about it. What up? Because, you know, I didn't have enough with 7 lives that I'm probably not going to be using at all. Let's make it 8. And also immediately lose my shield, because that's what I do. I act terrible at video games so people can laugh at me. See? Just like that. The fabled Gravis gamepad. I think it's one of the first 4-button gamepads in the industry. And Epic Mega Games liked to promote the hell out of the things. That was weird. Okay. Try to be careful, Julio. Like, seriously. I feel like there's supposed to be background here. I'm not entirely sure. Nothing there. Nothing there. Alright. We have hit the checkpoint. Ah! That's right, if you're gonna get hit, at least get hit during your invincibility frames, or as I call it, flash time. Even though the character is not necessarily flashing, but usually blinking. Or phasing in and out of existence. Yeah. Some health, including some health that I don't really need. Ah! Phew. Great job there. Let's fall down to the bottom and work our way back up. There we go. Bonus points! Okay, and oh. Well, that was my own fault. But that's kind of what I was saying about Run Like the Wind not being a good idea. Because running like the wind is going to result in you running into bad things. Orange cream soda, man. It's like sex. Except I'm having it. Moving on! So. Hey, it's cool if you don't know we're playing Chips Challenge all of a sudden. And very carefully trying to get around the obstacles. Ah! Quit being glitchy and slow. Thank you. Again, probably mostly a result of my computer really not being that great. Come on. Oh, excuse me. Scuchame. Or some such. You know what? I know that I said that I was going to try to avoid exploring everything, but it's what I like to call the gamer's prerogative, which is to collect everything in your path or out of your path, even though you probably don't need it. Pew pew pew. Okay. It's a kind of a shortcut. Just lets you bypass a few enemies. Which, if you're trying to go for 100%, you generally don't want to bypass enemies. Yeah. Yeah, let's go. Let's do this. There's our gem. And there we go. We got the gem. We got the gem. There we go. Some more ammunition. You know what? I'm gonna start breaking out the ammo here. We have just short of 700 rounds of toaster, so I think it's safe to start using it. Hey, it's a birdie friend. Birdie friend. Loving the music, by the way. Wow. That is not a way that I can go. This, however, is. It leads us to the end of the level. Pretty definitively to the end of the level, there is no way out of here. And that is another level clear for us. So it's off to bonus level 2, where I must now collect 35 gems. Yeah. Now the red pads here, my game will stop being dumb. The red pads will force Jazz to jump. There are also swirling pads that kind of spin them out. And things that are pretty much meant to force you to miss gems, make you lose control of Jazz, and possibly land directly into an exit sign. And hitting an exit sign before getting all of the gems. Out of my face. Yeah, hitting an exit sign means that you do not get the one up. Some very impressive graphics for its time, too. I mean, it basically looks like Mode 7. from the Super Nintendo. Now it's off to Medivo. Yeah, the bonus round basically looks like Super Nintendo Mode 7. Which, for its time, was really super impressive. And I like it, so I got no complaints. I think there's another bird buddy up there, but you can only have one at a time, so I shall unfortunately leave him in his cage. Oh, come on. Let's see. Alright, let's and pause this for a second. I get all super professional here and perform some computer maintenance while I'm trying to record a Let's Play. Yeah, my RAM usage is like super high. I think that might be part of the problem here. If it's not part of the problem, then it's part of the solution. Wait, that's not how it works. Yeah, I think that's a little better. Ah! Not so much for my birdie. My birdie! So much for my shield that... I seem to have a bad track record of... shields lasting all of 3 seconds. By the way, you can stand on horizontal spikes. Just don't try to fall off of them, because you will get stung. Now, the structure of this game is... there's going to be 3 planets, and on the 3rd planet we will be facing Devan Shell. This is the 3rd planet, so after the regular 2 levels, if we can survive that long, we're gonna be fighting Devan. And hopefully rescuing Eva Earlong. And we're not going to be rescuing Eva Earlong. You probably already knew that. Otherwise, there would not be 9 episodes of this. Certainly not 6. Or... ah. Nobody's getting sorted. I still have 9 mans left. Okay. Can I get up there? Yes. I am the champions, my friend. Now the rest of you shall perish. At the hands of the LFG 2000. All right, and here we start on the hoverboard segment. Most of the episodes have at least one hoverboard segment. I'm gonna try to not spend too much time here, because I remember during my test play spending way too much time on the hoverboard and not really finding anything, so... now... Let's talk DOSBox settings just briefly here. Now this isn't going to be a This Old DOS episode, this is a full Let's Play, but still, for anyone looking to play Jazz Jackrabbit, setting cycles to max is your best bet. I don't know anything about joystick settings because I don't use joysticks or joypads in DOSBox, generally. But, don't think there's anything up there. I will say this, I have had, personally, sound issues, or music issues, trying to play this with the Sound Blaster Pro setting. If you experience such issues, you may want to consider changing the sound card settings in the setup program to Gravis Ultrasound. That's what I'm using right now, and it seems to be working just fine. And already got a checkpoint. It's kind of weird. Okay. And up here is some more toaster ammo. Yep. And let's see how long this shield lasts. It's already kind of outlasted my expectations. Oh, and then I got hit by an enemy that I couldn't even see and lost my shield. Wasn't that unexpected? I'll give you a hint, no it wasn't. Ah. Another checkpoint. Pretty much right underneath the first one. This invincibility is actually taking a while. There we go. Now it's going away. Oh jeez! That was bad. I kind of don't want to die. Because the thing about dying is that you lose all of your rapid fire. Okay, back up to full health. Yep. Yep. Some very careful platforming here. Well, that's not creepy at all. Watch out, Devan. We're coming for you. We are coming right for you, because you're up next. That's some pretty good score. Level clear. And now here we go. Guardian says level 1. There's only one level of this. It's going to be happening on Medivo as well. Now there is a trick to this boss. I will tell you what the trick is and then not use it. The trick is just to stay here and fire at him. Because there is little he can do if you just do that. However, I'm going to get into this. Which is probably going to be a mistake. Oh, bollocks. And yeah, at least there are some rapid fire guns right there. I also lose all of my weapons, so But yeah, just cheaping out the boss like that is really not in the spirit of the game. So I'm trying to do this legit. If I get down to like one life or something, then I'll cheap it out. Until then, we're gonna try to do this legit. Okay, carefully now. Ah. Ish. That is me being terrible at video games and still being able to survive at the end. Final score of 122,000, 123,000, and 70 points. Jazz's adventures are just starting. Right now, the hideously dorky Devan Shell is constructing the twin mega battleships to blow up Jazz's home planet, Keratus. Eva Earlong awaits. Take your time, Jazz. Let's not keep her waiting. And then in the shareware version, you would have a blurb about how you're supposed to buy the game, blah, blah, blah. But we have the CD version. We don't have to worry about that. And next time on Let's Play Jazz Jackrabbit CD, Ballistic Bunny. I'm Coolio if you don't know. And I'll see you guys next time.